Man, it's been a while since I've actually been keeping up with seasonal anime. Leave it to Mob Psycho to force me to actually try and keep up. And of course, I was inevitably led to the Rising of Shield Hero, mostly because the quote-unquote controversy got a lot of people talking about it. To quickly address this, it's a dumb controversy, and the people who are really mad about it really need to calm down and go do something else. IHOP is open 24 hours a day, go pick up some pancakes and have a good time. That's all I'm saying about it, because I actually want to talk about the show itself. So after finishing the first couple of episodes, I wondered to myself, why exactly am I so hooked on this considering I've largely grown tired of the isekai genre? After giving it a bit of thought, I think it has a lot to do with what the show does different, what makes it stand out from the rest of the genre. They didn't just slap a smartphone in the main character's hands and call it a day. Instead, it seems like the writer actually wanted to be original. Whoa, who could have thought that was possible? So, if we look at a typical isekai, the genre can really be boiled down to a couple main plot points. Some loser is sent to a mysterious fantasy world where he instantly is surrounded by a harem of girls that absolutely adore him, has ridiculous powers beyond anyone else in the entire world, and the whole world just loves him, and the main character is a big bundle of giddy sarcastic mush so the viewer can place themselves in their shoes. A lot of this was popularized because of SAO. Love it or hate it, it was the one that really brought this idea into popularity. And since every show under the sun has tried to replicate it to varying degrees of success, we've had a lot of things coming out. Because of this, there's been an oversaturation of isekai anime, which isn't exactly going well considering the typical reaction to one of these shows now is, oh great, another one of these, next. Shield Hero had every option to copy these other shows, but despite still having a couple of tropes from the genre, the show manages to feel fresh because it changes a lot of these dumb tropes. Specifically, I'd say it breaks the mold in three very important ways. 1. The main character is actually really messed up, and justifiably so. 2. The world is against him from the start. 3. The character starts off at a massive disadvantage from everyone else. On point 1, it's really refreshing to see a character who isn't a bubbly mass of nothing. After arriving in the world, the guy gets completely screwed over from the start. Not only is he constantly insulted for being the shield hero, but then things all fall apart for him when this lady decides to completely screw him over by accusing him of sexual assault. Understandably, considering the circumstances, the guy is not too thrilled and decides that if the world's going to treat him like garbage, he might as well return the favor. Unlike the usual isekai protagonist who couldn't hurt a fly, this guy doesn't mind getting his hands dirty because he got screwed over. But as has been shown, the guy isn't a prick just because. When people treat him like a normal human being, he responds in kind. He even goes out of his way to save an entire village of people despite the fact that he wouldn't get any glory from it. The guy isn't evil, he's just been dealt a bad hand and is willing to return the favor if someone is actively a jerk. This means that the protagonist can be a lot more interesting, but also doesn't need to be outright evil. This creates a character with actual depth. Also of note are said people giving him a hard time, because yeah, he ain't getting any favors from this world. Unlike every other isekai protagonist, Naofumi doesn't just befriend everyone and get things done with the power of friendship. Quite the contrary, pretty much everyone despises him even before the false accusation. This guy just can't catch a break. This means that everything he accomplishes feels earned, and that every person that doesn't hate his guts only feels that way because he has to earn back their respect. It makes the actual struggle Naofumi goes through feel like it means something. Every friend he makes, every person that doesn't hate him, everything he does, he has to earn. And yeah, earning is important because this dude gets practically nothing. Forced to contend with a weapon that can't do damage from the onset, and having no money to speak of, this guy has to earn every level and every victory slowly. He needs to think carefully, plan, and get over his weaknesses if he wants to have any hope of surviving. He isn't some all-powerful dude who can strike down any monster by breathing in its direction. He needs to work hard to get anywhere, and this means that the plot is much more interesting. There's no guarantee he can overcome a problem, and there's no guarantee he can combat the oncoming disasters, meaning that the plot has actual stakes in this show. I've noticed in general, isekai with some kind of deviation from the norm always get way more attention. ReZero, Konosuba, Overlord, all of these shows have something about them that makes them unique. And likewise, Shield Hero succeeds because it also deviates from the genre in a lot of important ways. Having a protagonist that isn't a god, isn't a chick magnet, isn't loved by everyone, and isn't afraid of getting his hands dirty surprisingly makes the show a lot more fun to watch. It also helps that the show is generally both well written and well paced so far. I mean, seriously, it actually kind of hurts waiting for each episode to come out, and that's when you know you have a show that's really succeeded. And honestly, I think shows like Shield Hero are really important, because if this genre continues the way it's going and refuses to innovate or change, the genre will die out and fade like a fad. We need more shows like Shield Hero, ones willing to change things up for the sake of creativity. Sure, you can bank off the popularity of the genre by releasing some garbage, but what happens when the well dries up and no one remembers anything you made? Also, obligatory ref, Talia is amazing and deserves to be protected, comment, blah, blah, blah. We cool? We cool. Okay, I'm gonna go eat a sandwich. And hey, if you enjoyed this video, why not like the video and subscribe and check out my Patreon, I might link or maybe or whatever. I make theories. Go check those out. They're pretty good. And anyways, got another video coming up soon, so hopefully that's enjoyable, and then Death Note's next. Anyways, see you guys in the next video.